Why furosemide is used for hypercalcemia but not chlorothiazide? First of all, let us see what is hypercalcemia. So hypercalcemia is a condition which is a elevated levels of calcium within the serum. And we can also have a related term, hypercalciuria. And hypercalciuria is a elevated levels of calcium within the urine. So we should not confuse between these two terms, hypercalcemia and hypercalciuria. Hypercalcemia, the elevated levels of calcium within the serum, can result in a few of the symptoms like constipation, nausea and vomiting, and abdominal pain in the patients. And hypercalcemia, if it is not treated, can also lead to the cardiovascular problems with the elevated levels of calcium. On the other hand, hypercalciuria is a condition where there is increased excretion of the calcium within the urine, which may cause the formation of crystals within the urine. The elevated levels of calcium within the urine may result in the formation of renal stones in the patients. Now let us see what is the difference between the furosemide and chlorothiazide. Furosemide is one of the drug which is acting like a loop diuretic. On the other hand, chlorothiazide is the drug that belongs to the thiazide diuretics. Now what is the action of this furosemide and chlorothiazide in case of hypercalcemia, that is the elevated levels of calcium within the serum? So furosemide is going to increase the excretion of the calcium, thereby decreases the calcium levels within the serum. So furosemide inhibits the hypercalcemia. So that's why it can be indicated in this hypercalcemia. On the other hand, but chlorothiazide is the thiazide diuretic, which is going to increase the hypercalcemia by retaining the calcium within the blood. So chlorothiazide, as it increases the hypercalcemia, it should not be indicated in this condition. Now in this video, let us see why furosemide is going to increase the calcium excretion, while chlorothiazide is going to decrease the calcium excretion. First of all, let us see what is the action of furosemide. Furosemide is one of a loop diuretic which can affect the reabsorption of so many types of ions, thereby inhibits their excretion. For example, furosemide can inhibit the sodium reabsorption, calcium reabsorption, potassium reabsorption, magnesium reabsorption, as well as chloride reabsorption. So most of these monovalent and divalent cations reabsorption is going to be inhibited by furosemide. Because of inhibition of reabsorption of all these ions, the furosemide can increase the excretion of these ions within the urine. Now here our interest is on the calcium. So what is the effect of furosemide on the calcium? So furosemide is going to decrease the calcium reabsorption, thereby increase the calcium excretion in the urine. So in this way, furosemide can be used in the hypercalcemia where there is elevated levels of calcium within the plasma. Then the furosemide can increase the excretion of the calcium out of the body. But now let us see how this furosemide can inhibit the reabsorption as well as increase the excretion of these types of ions. Suppose this is the ascending loop of Henle, and this is the inside of the lumen, and this outside, that is the serum. The inner membrane of this lumen is called as apical membrane, and outer membrane is called as basolateral membrane. So within the ascending loop of Henle, the sodium should be reabsorbed into the systemic circulation into the serum. How it can be achieved? So on the apical membrane, one of the pump is present, sodium potassium 2 chloride symport. Symport is the pump which extends all the ions into the same direction. Now the sodium potassium 2 chloride symport present on the apical membrane can transport the sodium from the inside of the lumen to the renal tubular membrane. So sodium going to be reabsorbed here, and along with the sodium, potassium is also reabsorbed into the membrane. Along with this sodium and potassium, 2 chloride ions can also be reabsorbed. And here we can observe that this pump works in such a way, whenever 2 cations are reabsorbed, 2 anions are also reabsorbed, so the net change in the membrane potential is 0. So this pump works as an electrical neutrality pump, so that there is no change in the membrane potential. And once the sodium is present within the renal tubular membrane, it can be pumped out of this membrane into the serum by another pump, sodium potassium ATPase pump, which is present on the basolateral membrane. Now this pump will send the sodium outside, for which the potassium is going to be transported into the membrane. And again, this potassium can also be going out of the membrane for exchange with the chloride ions. So by action of these two pumps, sodium as well as chloride are going into the serum and potassium is recycled. And some of the potassium which is entering into the membrane can change the membrane potential. And because of the change in the membrane potential, the renal tubular membrane is depolarized, which can allow the entry of the calcium and magnesium between the tubular cell membrane so that calcium and magnesium are going to be reabsorbed. In this way, at ascending loop of Henle, so many types of ions are absorbed. Sodium is reabsorbed, chloride is reabsorbed, calcium and magnesium are reabsorbed, and potassium is actually recycled here, but it can be reabsorbed at the collecting tubules. So for reabsorption of all these type of ions, the important pump is the sodium potassium 2 chloride exchange pump, which is present on the apical membrane. Now let us see how furosemide acts. Furosemide is going to inhibit the sodium potassium 2 chloride exchange pump, thereby inhibits the reabsorption of all these types of ions. As furosemide inhibits the reabsorption of the calcium, furosemide can be used in the condition like hypercalcemia, where there is already elevated levels of calcium within the serum. Now let us see the action of chlorothiazide. Chlorothiazide is one of a thiazide diuretic, and its actions are similar to the furosemide with few exceptions. Chlorothiazide can also inhibit the sodium reabsorption, it can also inhibit the potassium reabsorption, it can inhibit the magnesium reabsorption. As the reabsorption of all these ions are decreased, the excretion of these ions are going to be increased by chlorothiazide. But what is the effect of this chlorothiazide on the calcium? Even chlorothiazide inhibits the reabsorption of so many types of ions, but its action on the calcium is somewhat different. Chlorothiazide is going to increase the calcium reabsorption. And this action of chlorothiazide on calcium is not related to its main action, but it is because of the action of the parathyroid hormone, which is responsible for the calcium reabsorption at the distal tubules. Now suppose this is the distal tubule and this is the basolateral membrane, and on the inner membrane, that is the apical membrane, one of the pump is present, that is the sodium and chloride exchange pump. This is a different pump compared with the pump at the ascending loop of Henle, where the sodium potassium 2 chloride exchange pump is present, but here only sodium and chloride exchange pump is present. So this pump is going to send the sodium into the membrane. At the same time, it sends the chloride again into the membrane. And again, this pump is having one cation going inside and one anion is going inside. So there is no change in the membrane potential. And this sodium is going to be exchanged then by the sodium potassium ATPase pump, where sodium is going outside and potassium is coming inside. And apart from these pumps, the distal tubule can also express few of the specialized ion channels which are responsible for the reabsorption of the calcium. Now this calcium can enter into the membrane through these specialized channels. The reabsorption of calcium through the specialized calcium channels is promoted by parathyroid hormone. Parathyroid hormone is responsible for the reabsorption of the calcium at the distal tubules. Now this calcium, which is present within the membrane, can be exchanged out of this membrane into the serum by another pump, sodium calcium exchange pump. In this way, at the distal tubule, sodium and chloride ions are reabsorbed through the sodium chloride exchange pump, but calcium reabsorption is mainly mediated through the specialized ion channels. Now what is the action of this chlorothiazide? Chlorothiazide is going to inhibit this pump, thereby it inhibits the reabsorption of the sodium chloride and few of the other ions, but it cannot affect the calcium reabsorption because the calcium reabsorption is mainly controlled by parathyroid hormone. So calcium is reabsorbed as usual, which increases the calcium levels within the plasma. That's why chlorothiazide should not be given in the hypercalcemia, where it increases the further levels of the calcium within the serum. Now let us see what is the conclusion. Now we have the two drugs, furosemide and chlorothiazide. Furosemide is going to increase the calcium excretion, whereas chlorothiazide is going to decrease the calcium excretion. Both are having quite opposite effects. Chlorothiazide cannot affect the calcium excretion because the calcium reabsorption is controlled by parathyroid hormone. And as furosemide is going to increase the calcium excretion, it can be used in the condition like the hypercalcemia, the elevated levels of calcium within the serum. At the same time, as it increases the calcium excretion, the furosemide should not be given in the condition like the hypercalciuria, where the elevated levels of calcium within the urine can form crystals in the urine. Similarly, chlorothiazide, as it decreases the calcium excretion, it should not be given in the condition like the hypercalcemia, but it can be given in the condition like the hypercalciuria, as it retains the calcium within the body so that it decreases the calcium excretion in the urine. So that's about the furosemide and chlorothiazide, which are quite similar in most of the actions, but their action on the calcium is quite opposite. Furosemide is going to increase the calcium excretion and chlorothiazide is going to decrease the calcium excretion. So furosemide can be given in the hypercalcemia, whereas chlorothiazide is contraindicated in the hypercalcemia.